Welcome to Learnistan. I, Dr. Nitin Kumar Saxena, starting a new course on research methodology. This course will be a 50 video series which I will try to complete in 4 months. So before I start, just a small introduction of mine. I am an associate professor with a renowned B school based in Delhi NCR. So this is a brief profile of mine. So let's start with the course. So let's see the learning outcomes of this session. At the end of this session, you will be able to answer what is the meaning of research, what are the different applications of research, objective of research, what is the difference between research methods and research methodology, what are the features that lead to a good research, and lastly, what are the problems encountered by researchers. It is said that research is a systematic gathering of information. Why is it said so? Because this helps us in our search for truth. Thus, we can say research is a systematic effort to gain new knowledge. We can also summarize research as research is the systematic process of collecting and analyzing information in order to increase our understanding of the phenomena about which we are concerned or interested. Three keywords to be noted here: that first, research is a systematic process; second, research is all about collecting data; third, research includes analyzing the information so that we arrive at the desired results. So before we go into detailed understanding of research, research methods and research methodology, let us understand the application of research, why it is important to learn research methodology. So let's see. Research has numerous benefits for all the professions, for all the streams under the sun. For example, for a service provider, research helps to find out the answers to the problems like, how many people are using my service? Why they will use my service? Or how satisfied my customers are? With answers to this question, a research provider can always improvise on service. Consumers. As a consumer, research helps you to find answers for the questions like, how good are the service providers? What are the long-term effects of the product that I am using? Or am I getting value for money? On the other hand, from the administrator or a manager point of view, answers to the question can be found out like, what are the needs of the community? How can the effectiveness of workers be improved? What are the training needs of my staff? Similarly, a professional can find answers to the questions like, what is the most effective solution to the problem? How valid is the particular theory in the present situation? What is the relationship between X and Y? Similarly, if you are a sales manager, research will help you to find answers to questions like, how much are consumers prepared to spend on this product? What are the attributes of a good salesperson? Or research may also help you to find answers to theoretical questions like, which are the most effective intervention for a particular phenomena? Or what is the best way to find out the effectiveness of a particular treatment? So we have seen that the application of research can be witnessed in all the domains of study. Coming to our next topic, which is objective of the research. So the first objective is to gain familiarity with a new theory or an idea by extensive investigation, reading to a master each and every concept related to it. This objective is easily achieved under exploratory research studies. To portray accurately the characteristics of a particular individual, situation, or a group. This can be summarized under descriptive research study. Third objective is to determine the frequency with which something occurs or with which it is associated with something else, covered under diagnostic research studies. And the last objective is to draw conclusions by conducting rigorous tests and thereby formulating hypothesis with a solid mathematical proof, which is covered under hypothesis testing research study. Coming to difference between research methods and research methodology. So, what are research methods? Research methods are the methods or techniques employed by a researcher in conducting a research operation. Research methods are broadly categorized into three groups. First, those methods which are concerned with collection of data. Second, those techniques which are used for establishing a relationship between data and the unknowns. And last, are the methods which are used to evaluate the accuracy of the results obtained. Whereas research methodology is the scientific and systematic way to solve a research problem. We can see that research methodology has a wider scope than research methods. Thus, we can say that when we talk about research methodology, we not only talk about research methods, also consider the logic behind the methods we use in the context of research study and explain why we are using a particular method or technique and why we are not using others, so that research results are capable of being evaluated either by the researchers himself or by others. So the next topic is features of a good research. So the first feature of a good research is clearly stated purpose. That is, a good research should have a very clearly stated purpose. This not only refers to the objective of the study, but also precisely define the scope and domain of the study, the variables and the construct that are being investigated, like service delivery models, quality standards, inventory management, need to be defined in a clear and precise terms. Second feature is systematic and detailed plan. This means that the research should be structured with specified steps to be taken in a specified sequence, that too in a well-defined set of rules. This does not mean that it rules out creative thinking, but certainly reject the use of guessing and intuition in arriving at the conclusions. The third step is, a good research is one which is supported by the logical justifications. The selection of techniques of collecting information, sampling plans, and data analysis technique must be supported by a logical justification, which give a robust planning to your research. Logical property of the research makes research more meaningful in context of taking decisions. Next is unbiased, objective, and neutral manner of a research. The results of the study must be prepared and presented in an unbiased, objective, and neutral manner. The significant findings can be best supported by past research, research approach, and limitations, or by the expert opinion. Fifth feature of a good research is highest ethical standards. Research at every stage and at any cost should maintain a highest ethical standard. The next is, a research must be replicable. The reason for this structured, ethical, justifiable, and objective approach is the fact that the research carried out must be replicable. This means that the process followed by us must be reliable. That is, in case the study is carried out under similar constraint and conditions, it should be able to reveal similar results. Next is problem encountered by the researchers. The first problem faced by the researchers is the lack of scientific training in the methodology of the research. Across the globe, researchers are facing the problem of lack of scientific training given to them on methodology. Second, no code of conduct for researchers. There is no strictly or clearly defined code of conduct for the researchers. This leads to the plagiarism, copying of the research, publishing the research of one researcher in the name of other. All these things are leading to the demotivation to the researchers. Next is difficulty in timely available of the published data. every research has to be supported by a robust review of literature. Every result has to be supported by the pre-published research. And due to the non-availability of the published data, researchers find difficulty in supporting their results and arriving at a robust research design for their study. Next is lack of confidence that the data or information obtained from a business unit will not be misused. So there is a lack of confidence in the business units in the organization that when they share the information with the researchers, the information can be misused. So this is also happening because there is no code of conduct for the researchers. Next is insufficient interaction between all concerned for better and realistic research. That is, a researcher should be in constant touch with the university people, with the people who grant funds for the research, with the key decision makers of the industry for getting the data or getting the inputs. And because of the insufficient interaction, we can say because of the lack of confidence between the different parties, there is a difficulty in arriving at a robust and clear research. And last is research overlapping and poor library management. Because of the poor code of conduct, lack of scientific training, there is a lot of instances where there is a research overlap. That means two or more researchers are doing almost same type of study. First, second, there is also a probability that though the published data is available, but because of the poor library management, researchers are not able to access the required data in a timely manner. So with this, we conclude our first session on Introduction to Research Methodology. Learners, if you have any doubt or questions, you can leave a comment and I will try my best to answer these queries. Learners, sharing is caring. So I will like you or I will request you to share this video with all your friends so that your friends can be benefited and we are able to create a community of researchers around us. Stay safe, stay connected. Bye.